Well, I'm back on the road again, so that gives you more time to subscribe if you haven't already. Conquest of Credits, Day 2, Busch Gardens, Williamsburg.
Hey everybody, coming to you today from Busch Gardens, Williamsburg. Let's get after it.
So I started my day off at Busch Gardens, Williamsburg with Apollo's Chariot. This was one of B&M's first hypercoasters, if not the first one, I believe. It was an awesome ride. I really enjoyed the airtime. It wasn't the best hypercoaster from B&M that I've ever been on. Actually, the only other one is Diamondback at Kings Island. I think one of my favorite aspects of Apollo's Chariot was how it drops down near the Rhine River. Alright, so just got off of Apollo's Chariot. That was a fun ride for, I think it was B&M's first attempt at a hypercoaster. So it was really fun, not too bad at all, definitely re-rideable. I didn't get a chance to ride Loch Ness Monster, but it looks pretty good. The wait was really long and it went down a few times, so yeah, I can't wait to get back to give it a try.
Open already.
So Busch Gardens Williamsburg has a lot of pros going for it. I would say the only con was not being able to ride Pantheon, but we will be able to do that next year. Can't wait.
To enjoy a ride on Tempesto.
All right, also, just got off of Tempesto, as you can see right back there. It wasn't my favorite. On that second launch upwards, once you right before you get into that inversion, I grayed out a little bit. I wasn't expecting it to be, I guess forceful or not. Just got real lightheaded. Not sure if that was normal or not. It is super hot out here, so I just drank a glass of water. So hopefully that's not how it's gonna feel all day, but yeah, I think the way that made me feel, one and done.
We are here in the Fest House, here to have some lunch. Today, on the menu, we have pepperoni pizza, pepperoni and bacon pizza. We have a salad. We also have some cheesecake for dessert.
Well, like I said, we're in the Fest House. As you can see, they normally have a show in here. I believe it's called the Oompa Band. They just finished up as I sat down. So, but yeah, let's give this a taste here. All right, so obviously salad gonna be all right. I think I got most of it on the plate, on the tray. Good. I'm not even sure how you eat this. Not bad.
I was also unable to get the credit for Alpengeist. I really can't wait to get back because this inverted coaster looks absolutely amazing. Thank you.
Just got off of Verbolten. That was fun. The drop track is rough, so it was all right. I would do it again. Kind of cool. Yeah, pretty fun.
Griffin was also one that I missed on my trip. It had a pretty long wait to start off the day, and then it went down for a while, and then it had another long wait towards the end of the evening, so I will have to get it on my next trip to Busch Gardens. And of course, when I was trying to get audio and video of Escape from Pompeii, there was a ton of music playing in the background, so I don't want to get copyrighted. So here we are with some nice music and video footage of Escape from Pompeii and me soaking them. Well, that's going to do it for our trip to Busch Gardens Williamsburg. Overall, it's one of my favorite parks that I've ever visited. Very beautiful, very scenic, and I can't wait to get back to get the rest of the credits there. Stay tuned for the next video in the Conquest of Credits series. And don't forget, if you enjoyed the video, give it a like. It really helps us out. Also, subscribe to us on YouTube and give us a like on Instagram and Facebook. And we will see you out at the parks.